I am desperate for anything to ease the burden, for something new, to give me anything that's certain, longing for a change, looking for escape, searching for a reason not to stay the same, but in your hands I remain. I choose to heed your call and leave it up to you, you who see my rise and fall. So cleanse me, disturb me, shake me to my core. Make me.
Good morning, brothers and sisters!
Welcome sa isa na namang linggo na punong-puno ng blessing dito sa The Feast at Home Rizal District. Ako po si Sis Vanny.
At ako po si Bro H ng Worship Ministry. Bago ang lahat, nais po naming batiin ang ating mga lola at lola dyan ng Happy Grandparents Day!
Happy Grandparents Day! Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagmamahal at pag-aaral.
Yan. Kamusta po kayo lahat? Tayo na ay ngayon ay nasa 4 months na kagad, ano? Bilis. Dati March lang tapos nag-pandemic. Ngayon, magpapasko na kagad. So marami sa atin ang miss na miss na yung mga kamag-anak natin para makipag-get together, mga kaibigan natin. Yan. At syempre kami mga servants, miss na miss na po namin mag-serve ng live para sa inyong lahat.
Opo, pero huwag kayong mag-alala. We are praying and claiming that this pandemic will end soon at makapag-get together po tayong lahat. Pero habang nag-aantay po tayo, meron pa rin ways para makapag-connect at inaanyahan po namin kayo to join our light groups.
Yan, marami po tayong light groups. We have the youth para sa mga kabataan natin, singles, couples ministry, and kung gusto nyo po mag-serve, no? Pwede po kayo mag-join sa amin. We have our intercessory ministry, yung mga engagers po natin, we have the media, and of course, we have the worship ministry.
Yes, kaya mag-comment lang po kayo sa baba kung saang ministry nyo po gustong mag-serve at kung saang light group nyo po gustong mag-join. And let's also be a blessing to others by sharing today's talk. So ready ka na bang mag-bless, Bro H?
Ready na. Kaya let's join our worship team as we give praise and thanks to the Lord.
When night has fallen and fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. Feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo, echo in my soul. So says to me,
whoa, now there's no stopping what you have started until it is complete.
When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me.
Yeah,
I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out.
like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo, echo in my soul. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out,
yeah.
Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo, echo in my soul.
Feel the presence of the Lord. He is here with us right now. Yes, Lord, we honor you and we adore you and we worship you. Gusto ko munang batiin ang lahat ng mga lolo at lola. Kasama na ako ng isang happy Grandparents Day. Araw natin ito at nawa may maglibre sa atin o may magregalo. Sa mga anak at mga apo, huwag niyong palampasin ang araw na ito nang hindi nagpapasalamat sa kanila. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I encourage you to continue giving, donating and tithing even during this time of crisis. We have posted and shown ways for you to be able to continue giving to Feast Rizal. I believe that God will bless you more. Sabi sa Lucas 6 verse 38, give and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Are you ready to receive God's abundant blessings today? Kunin nyo yung nabina to God's love, and all together, let's declare, today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself to God's word, so I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I'm God's beloved, I'm God's servant, I'm God's powerful champion, and because I'm blessed, I'm blessing the world. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's ask God to bless our dream. Alam niyo, maraming pangarap tayo, hindi na natuloy o hindi matutuloy this year, 2020. But I believe hindi pa panahon para mangyari yan. And we have to continue dreaming. Patuloy tayong mangarap, and God will, I'm sure, bless all our dreams. Let's lift them all up to God. Father God in heaven, we are lifting up to you all our dreams. Marami pong pangarap kami, hindi lamang sa aming sarili, hindi lamang sa aming pamilya, sa aming mga mahal sa buhay, kundi pati sa aming negosyo, sa aming trabaho, sa aming pinagkikitaan. Yes, O Lord God, we are lifting them all up to you at naniniwala kami. May matindi kaming pananiwala at pananampalataya na mangyayaring lahat ang mga ito sa pamamagitan mo. In Jesus' mighty name, Amen. Brothers and sisters, ang pwede nating sandalan at panghawakan sa panahon ng crisis na katulad ng nararanasan natin ngayon at sa mga sandali ng kagipitan, kaguluhan at kawalan ng pag-asa, ang salita ng Diyos. The Word of God. Last Sunday, we talk about the story of the leper who was healed by Jesus by touching him and declaring, "Be healed." This is the first miracle story in the Gospel of Matthew after the Sermon on the Mount. But the first miracle done by Jesus before he started his public ministry happened in a wedding celebration at Cana in Galilee. We can read it in John 2, verses 1 to 11. It was Mama Mary, whose birthday we celebrated last September 8, who made Jesus did the miracle. During the festivities, the wine supply ran out. So Mama Mary told Jesus, "They have no more wine." Anong sabi ni Jesus? Jesus replied, "Dear woman, that's not our problem. My time has not yet come." But his mother knew that in order to see his power at work, there was one key. And what's that? Obedience. Kaya ang sabi niya sa mga servants, "Do whatever he tells you." It is the same way with us. Our obedience opens the door to see his power manifest in our lives. Scripture says, if we are willing and obedient, we will eat the good of the land. In other words, we will experience God's abundant blessings when we follow His commands. When the servants obeyed Jesus and filled the jars with water, what happened? The water turned into wine. There was a miracle. And the same will happen to us. Miracles will happen in our lives if we obey Jesus. Amen? Itutuloy natin ang malalim na pag-aaral sa Gospel ni Matthew. Pagkatapos ng 18 talks na ginawa natin tungkol sa Sermon on the Mount, we are now in the second miracle story. Pangalawa na po ito. And so I would like to welcome you to talk number 2. Make me believe. In this beautiful yet controversial story, Jesus meets a godly military man, isang Roman officer. And I would like to take this opportunity to give honor to all the men and women in uniform, frontliners in this pandemic crisis. We honor you for this sacrifice. We are able to stay at home because you are serving. Thank you so much. And we also pray for those in the medical field, transport and delivery, and for all frontliners. We pray for your protection, health, and blessing. In our key passage today, Jesus said that this guy's faith is phenomenal. Nakakalungkot. Madalas na ginagamit natin ang salitang faith, pero we no longer really know what it means. Madalas nating marinig o sabihin sa mga may problema, magtiwala ka lang sa Diyos. Pero ano ba talaga ang ibig sabihin ito? What does faith mean? Some people think faith is a mental assent or mental assent. You agree to that God exists. Pero hanggang doon lang. That's like saying, "I'm married to my wife." That means I believe she exists. Because in the Bible, faith is relational. Faith is trust. Ang pananampalataya ay pagtitiwala. Yes, faith is a covenantal relationship with God. Here's today's key passage in Matthew 8, verses 5 to 13. Let's read all together. When Jesus returned to Capernaum, a Roman officer came and pleaded with him, "Lord, my young servant lies in bed, paralyzed and in terrible pain."
Lord said, Jesus said, I will come and heal him. But the officer said, Lord, I'm not worthy to have you come into my house. Just say the word from where you are and my servant will be healed. I know this because I'm under the authority of my superior officers and I have authority over my soldiers. I only need to say, go and they go, or come and they come. And if I say to my slaves, do this, they do it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed. Turning to those who were following him, he said, I tell you the truth. I haven't seen faith like this in all Israel. Wala pa siyang nakitang ganitong katatag ng pananampalataya. Sana ganito rin kalalim at katindi ang pananampalataya natin. Would you want Jesus tell you that your faith is phenomenal too? Would you want Jesus to brag about you and say, I haven't seen faith like this? Tuloy natin ang pagbasa. And I tell you this, that many Gentiles will come from all over the world, from east and west, and sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the feast in the kingdom of heaven. But many Israelites, those from whom the kingdom was prepared, will be thrown into outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then Jesus said to the Roman officer, go back home because you believe. It has happened. And the young servant was healed that same hour. Brothers and sisters, how many of us have that kind of faith of the Roman officer? Let's pray to heaven. Jesus, deepen my faith, deepen my trust, deepen my obedience. Today I choose you. I declare that I'm under your authority. With your power at work in my life, I will obey you in Jesus' mighty name. The Word of God. Today, I want to preach the message, Just Say the Word. My friend, make this your prayer. Make this your spiritual posture. Let's pray together. Just say the word. Ulitin natin. Just say the word. We just read the second miracle story after the Sermon on the Mount. In these miracles, what was Jesus doing? He was repeating himself. Listen, he was practicing what he was preaching. He was walking the talk. Ginagawa niya kung ano ang sinasabi niya. I said this last week. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus explained his kingdom through his words. Now, he was explaining the kingdom through his works. And in this century story, or in this centurion story, Jesus was doing three things. He was preaching again, love your enemies. He was preaching again, do not judge. He was preaching again, not everyone who calls me Lord. To explain further what I'm saying, and continue the last talk, or continue the talk, let's all welcome Brother Woody Quiros.
Thank you, Brother Godi. In this centurion story, Jesus puts into action three things that Jesus preached in the Sermon of the Mount. Namely, love your enemies, do not judge, and not everyone who calls me Lord. So let us dissect each one of them. Let's start with the loving your enemies. You know, two chapters before this story, Jesus said, but I say, love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. And now he was going to dramatize this right before their eyes, no? When he said Jesus returned to Capernaum, a Roman officer came and pleaded with him, "Lord, my young servant lies in bed, paralyzed and in terrible pain." And Jesus said, "I will come and heal him." You know, this story is very shocking to the Jewish people. Why do I say this? Because in Jesus' time, the Jews hated the Romans because they represented everything that the Jews stood against, like pagan beliefs, idol worship, immoral practices such as abortion and infanticide, and the suppression of the Israelites' claim to be the holy nation governed solely by God's law. And the Romans, they killed people, they abused women, they demanded taxes. So, what is there not to hate? Let me give you an analogy. You know, my parents lived during World War II. My mom was around 10 years old when she had to pack up and with the family escape to a nearby island, yung Samal Island, off the coast of Davao City, just to avoid the atrocities being done by the Japanese soldier in the city. So you can just imagine kung gaano yung galit ng mga Pinoy sa mga Hapon, ng mga sundalo ng mga Hapon, dahil sa mga nangyayari noon. Para sa mga Pinoy noon, sa mga Pilipino, they were monsters. So, let's try to capture the inner conflict of the Jews, how they felt, no, when they saw the Roman centurion with Jesus. No? Let's take a time machine. At sabay-sabay po tayo pumunta doon sa panahon noong 1941. Nasa gitna po tayo ng gera noon. At sa isang bahay, secretly nag-hold tayo ng ating prayer meeting. So meron tayo mga 10 to 15 po tayo doon, nagdadasal at nag-start ng worship. At sa kalagitnaan ng worship, may biglang pumasok isang Japanese soldier na kayuniforme at may dalang baril. No? Nung pumasok siya, siyempre nabigla tayo lahat. Tumingin siya sa atin at biglang sumabay sa ating worship. Ano kayang nararamdaman niyo, mga kapatid? Dahil nung nakita niyo yung Hapon, yung kanyang uniforme, and that thing symbolizes bombing, torture, death, and starvation. So, mixed emotion ka, no? Hindi mo alam kung anong pakiramdam mo. Galit ka, pero nalilito ka. Bakit ganon? No? Biglang pumasok at parang out of nowhere, sasabayan tayo sa ating pag-worship sa ating Panginoon. In the Bible story, it was not just a Roman soldier, no? Hindi ito ordinaryo na Roman soldier ang lumapit sa ating Panginoon, kundi isang Roman centurion, no? At ano po yung mga Roman centurion? Ito po mga opisyales. These are officers in the Roman army, and they commanded 80 Roman soldiers. So, mabigat ang kanilang posisyon. And when the Jews look at him, he was the embodiment of the enemy. Kaya imaginein mo na lang kung yung mga Hudyo noon ay umaten po ng isang anger management workshop, no? At kung saan sila ay binigyan ng mga kutsilyo at sinabi sa kanila, sige, maghanap kayo ng mga picture diyan na gusto niyong pag-stab. No? Malamang at malamang ang pipiliin nilang picture doon dito itong sa Roman centurion, no? At saka pagsasaksak sa akin nila 'yon, no? But kung tingnan natin, ano yung reaction ng ating Panginoon when the Roman centurion asked him or pleaded with him? He said, "I will come. I will come." Brothers and sisters, at this point, I have a couple of questions for you. The first one is, who are your enemies? Are they the people who harm you? Are these the people who look down on you? People who don't like you? Or people that you don't like? And when was the last time you loved your enemy? And the second question is, has an enemy ever needed you? And you answered, I will come. Brothers and sisters, this is what makes the kingdom of Jesus special. Every kingdom of this world is busy loving their friends, but hating their enemies. But not in the kingdom of Jesus. Let me share with you this story of a famous Filipino actress. Kilala po natin ito, si Cherry Pie Picache. No? In September 2014, Cherry Pie's mom was brutally murdered. And the day after that incident, a devastated Cherry Pie said, hindi siya sigurado kung makakapagpatawad pa siya ulit. And even called for the return of the death penalty. At ito yung sinabi niya, ito yung pagkasabi niya, no? Iba rin talaga ang Diyos. You talk about forgiveness, you talk about, kasi anti-death penalty ako. But now, iniisip ko, what drives people to commit all this violence? Lahat yun mapuput into test sa iyo in times like this. 2 weeks later, Michael Flores, who had been a helper in Cherry Pie's mom's house for 6 months, was arrested and he confessed to the killing of Cherry Pie's mom in a robbery attempt. He also admitted that he was under the influence of Shabu when he and two other companions carried out the crime. And during her mom's wake, Cherry Pie was asked the question, is there a possibility that you will forgive your mom's killer? And her answer, I don't know now. But you pray, and you continue to pray. Kasi wala kang kakapitan. Siya lang. Pero pasensya ngayon, hindi buo sa puso ko nasagutin ang tanong mo. In the 5 years since her mom's death, Cherry Pie's journey of healing has included being a speaker in different organizations and parishes. And her topic? Forgiveness. And she said, ngayon ko napatunayan, God really took over. It's really by His grace that I was able to do it. While I was walking, when I was about to see Him, desidido ako, pero ang pinagdadasal ko, magagawa ko ba? So I was really praying, Lord, please take over. Iba, hindi ako makapaniwala. What Cherry Pie was referring was that was about her experience of coming face to face with Flores, who was convicted in December 2015 with the penalty of reclusion perpetua or life imprisonment. Sabi nga niya, sabi ni Cherry Pie, dinalhan ko pa siya ng pasalubong, no? At hindi ko akalain magagawa ko na bigyan siya ng tinapay itong taong pumatay sa mama ko. Buong puso ko siya pinapatawad. And Cherry Pie added that she plans to regularly visit Flores para ma-restore both yung healing namin magtuloy-tuloy. You know, brothers and sisters, in the eyes of the world, what Cherry Pie did was foolish. Even her siblings were angry at her for doing what she did. But you see, such actions do not belong to this world. It belongs to Jesus. Cherry Pie's actuations belongs to God's kingdom, or God's crazy kingdom, where you love your enemies. At this point, brothers and sisters, let us welcome Brother Nap, our feast builder from Feast Cardona, who will share with us the next two things that Jesus did.
Thank you, Brother Woody. To continue on a very powerful message on today's healing and miracles, talk to Make Me Believe. Maybe you're still wondering why Make Me Believe. Let me share with you. Jesus was preaching again, do not judge. Yes, Jesus is preaching again, do not judge. No? We will go back a bit, one page before this story, and you will find Jesus establishing a point to strengthen a very difficult teaching of not judging. The way he dealt with the centurion. It says, "Do not judge others and you will not be judged. And why worry about the speck in your friend's eye when you have a log in your own?" Yan. In Matthew 7, 1 and in Matthew 7, verse 3. Yan ang sinasabi. Do not judge and you will not be judged. And why worry about the speck of your friend's eye when you have log on your own? Yan. This is somehow a statement of Jesus where he shows us how not to judge. Instead, help people experiencing the pain of their sin. Tutulungan natin yung mga taong nagdadalamhati because of their sin. If you want to help people recover from failure, do not condemn them. The word judge, because literally means separate or distinguish. Yan ho yung literal meaning ng judge. When you judge, you establish yourself as good and separate those you think are bad. The moment you judge. No, yan ang sinasabi sa atin dito. The problem with us, whenever we judge, nakakalimutan na natin that we are all sinners. Yes, we are all sinners because the Bible says in Romans 3 verse 10, none is righteous. No, not one. Wala ho masasabi natin dito very righteous. Wala ho, lahat ho tayo are sinners. The story continues in Matthew 8, verse 8 to 10, where the title, "Make Me Believe," came in. It says, "But the officer said, 'Lord, I'm not worthy to have you come into my home. Just say the word from where you are, and my servant will be healed.' When Jesus heard this, he was amazed. Turning to those who were following him," "he said, 'I tell you the truth, I haven't seen faith like this in all of Israel.'" Yeah. "I haven't seen faith like this in all Israel." This is indeed a very controversial story. Why? Because it showed that Jesus, instead of judging, distinguishing, or separating good people, he saw goodness in his enemy. Why enemy? Remember, the centurion is an officer of the Roman Empire. No? Galit na galit siya sa mga Jew. Yan. He was a fan of pagan. Yan, yung centurion yan, they don't believe. In our life, we are faced with so many difficult people. Marami tayong nakakasalimuho ng mga tao. May mga tayong kaaway. But when you start seeing the goodness of somebody, it changes your perspective. Naranasan nyo ba yun? Galit na galit ka doon sa tao, pero pag nakaharap mo na siya at nakakita ka ng kabutihan sa kanya, lumalambot ang puso mo. Di mo ba na-experience yun? Lumalambot ang puso mo. In the same way, sabi natin, Jesus saw their goodness in the enemy. Yan. Let's admit it. We are not usually like Jesus. Hindi naman tayo talaga parating katulad ni Jesus. Sa totoo lang. Mahilig tayo sa kami-kami na lang. Dapat. We want exclusivity. Tayo lang yan. Tayong grupo lang. Tayo lang. We don't like anyone outside of our group. Yan. We judge others quickly just because they don't belong. Pag hindi natin kasama, dinajudge natin yung mga tao yan. Iba ang kanilang pananaw. And sadly, we become judgmental. Hindi tayo pareho ng pananaw niyan. Ating kasama yan. Because they don't behave how we behave. Naku, iba ugali niya, katulad natin. It's a good thing, mga kapatid, in our peace light and our peace of the light of Jesus community. Yung ating peace po na sinasabi natin, we welcome everybody. Yes, you heard me right. We welcome everybody. It's an open tent. It's just like a tent where you can come and you can go. Labas ka, pasok ka, balik ka uli, no? We reach out to the unchurched. Yan yung hinahanap natin yung mga taong unchurched. The unbelievers. It is not an exclusive for Catholics only. Hindi ho. Hindi po to exclusive for Catholics only. Yes, we start to do the mass for those na gusto magsimba ho sa atin. Katulad ho namin, we are Catholic. Gusto namin simulan ng araw ng mimas. Jesus is saying, "I am different. We're different. My kingdom is different. You must see goodness in your enemy. Yan. I see goodness in your enemy. Let me share to you a story about John Wooden. You know, for those basketball aficionados, no, yung mga nanonood na mga noong-noong pa, no, John Wooden is a former coach of UCLA, yan, from 1948 to 1975. What was amazing with this guy is his temper, yung kanyang pag-uugali. He seldom left his seat or stand up if his player lose their temper or gets out of control. Hindi siya katulad ng mga ngayon, ng mga coach na pag nagkamali lang, tayo ka agad. Tinuturo-turo pa yung referee o nagagalit o minsan, you know, uttering bad words, no? For John, modeling was better than words, no? With that philosophy, he sets a record that never been broken in college basketball. 88 game winning streak with a loss record of 885 to 203. Ganun ang winning record niya, 885 winning and 203 lost. You know, sila Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, sila Bill Walton, sila Hazard played under him. You know, he was not critical of others because he always say, "I'm not a judge. I'm not a judge." No? Parati nga siyang pinoprovoke, "But coach, hindi ka nagagalit." You know, sabi niya, "I'm not a judge." Eh, yung pananaw nila, "I'm not a judge." Friends, you must see goodness in your enemy. You must see goodness in your enemy. Remember in the Sermon at the Mount, it's all about the teaching of Jesus. But chapter 7, sabi natin, ending of the Sermon at the Mount, now it's where the rubber hit the road. Yan ang sinasabi natin because Jesus is now practicing what He teaches to set an example to us. Yan. Kung ano'y tinuturo ni Jesus doon sa Sermon at the Mount, pagbaba niya, eto na, it's where the rubber hit the road. Pinapractice niya kung ano'y sinasabi niya para maging ehemplo natin. And finally, sabi natin, He was preaching again, "Not everyone who calls me Lord," yan ang sinasabi niya, "not everyone who calls me Lord," sabi niya. Just a few verses before this, Jesus said, "Not everyone who calls out to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. Only those who actually do the will of the Father in heaven will enter." Yan, sinabi niya yan. Remember, the Jews believe that of all nations sa buong mundo, they are closest to God. Until now, sabi nila, they are the chosen one. No, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Yan ang belief nila eh. And remember, the definition of holy, sabi na, definition of holy for them is set apart. Set apart, naiiba tayo, special, unique, one of a kind. Yan po ang ibig sabihin ng holy sa kanila. Set apart. But now, their sworn enemy, this Roman centurion, had stronger faith than they had. Mas malakas pa pala pananampalataya ng centurion na to kesa sa kanila. What a shock. Nakakashock talaga. Can you imagine how threatening this was to the religious Jew? May kaagaw na sila suddenly. Dati sila lang. No? Their sworn enemy, this Roman centurion, had stronger faith than they had. Mas malakas ang pananampalataya. You know, it reminds me of a story of Toy Story 1. Yan. A movie, Toy Story 1, premiered November of 1995. Yan. A movie, Toy Story 1, premiered November 1995. Maybe hindi mo na matandaan ito. Ako hindi ko na nga natatandaan ito. Nakalimutan ko na ito. But my grandchildren, si Checo and Trent, love to watch it over and over again. Kaya nga na nakapagbakasyon ako sa kanila sa Melbourne, I can no longer watch Netflix. Basta sa kanila, paulit-ulit. Pag galing sa eskwela, pagdating doon, "Dad, nap, I want to watch Toy Story." Paulit-ulit yan. No? Yan. Yan po yung Toy Story 1 picture. Just in case you haven't watched it, kung hindi niya napanood dito, let me share to you the plot of the story. Toy Story is about Andy. Andy is a 6-year-old boy who had many toys. Ang daming laruan ni Andy. 6 years old siya, natural. Talagang punong-puno ng laruan. Yan. But his favorite toy was always Sheriff Woody. Paboritong-paborito niya yan. And Woody was happy that a special spot in Andy's room and on this heart. Yan, happy si Woody kasi siya special eh. Nilalagay siya doon sa favorite spot niya eh. Tsaka siya yung talagang chosen na toy ni Andy. Yan. For example, if Andy was going out on a trip, he would leave all his toys. Iiwanan niya lahat ng mga toy niya. And we'd always bring Woody in his backpack. Yun lang ang nakalagay dito sa likod niya. Sa dami ng laruan niya, kukunin niya itong si Woody, Sheriff Woody. Yun lang ang dadali niya. But one day, he received a new toy for his birthday. Guess what? And I know yung mga bata dyan, naalala nila yan, tuwan-tuwa rin sila. Si Buzz Lightyear. Yan, may bago siyang laruan. Andy liked it so much, he placed it in the spot that once reserved for Woody alone. Yung dating lugar ni Woody na wala na, nandudu na si Buzz Lightyear. And one day, when Andy went on a trip, he left Woody and brought Buzz Lightyear with him. Hindi lang nawalan ng lugar kung saan niya tinatago, hindi niya pa sinasama kung saan siya pupunta. Iba na yung laman ng backpack niya, si Buzz Lightyear na. Yan. Imagine how Woody felt. Imaginin mo yun kung ikaw yun. No? He felt crushed. Nagdudugo yung puso. From favored one, then suddenly no more. And I bet ganun ho naramdaman ng mga Jews noon. When Jesus said, right after praising the pig of the centurion, sabi ni Jesus, this is what Jesus said, eto yon, and I tell you this, that many Gentiles will come from all over the world, marami yan, from east to west, and sit down with Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, at the feast in the kingdom of heaven. But many Israelites, those for whom the kingdom was prepared, will be thrown away into an outer darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of the teeth. Yan. Will be thrown into outer darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of the teeth. Ouch! Sabi nga natin, kung ikaw yung mga Jews, those words really stung. Because the Jews, like Woody, all of a sudden, their special spot in God's room has been taken away. Nawala sila bigla and given to the newcomer. And worse than that, yung pumalit sa kanila, a worse enemy pa nila. But that's the message. Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord shall enter the kingdom. Remember, past is past. Jesus is asking, sabi niya dito, so what if you called me Lord yesterday? Are you following me as your Lord today? Yan. Let's pause for a while, no? Tinatawag natin siyang Lord, Lord kahapon, pero today, amidst all the difficulty that we encounter, are you following Jesus as our Lord today? Think about it. Friends, just a reminder, don't depend on yesterday's anointing. Don't depend on yesterday's anointing. We fall on the same mistake the Jews were making. We sit passively, knowing that God chose us in the past. Ay, kami na to. Walang pagkakamali. Kami yan, kami lang ang maliligtas. But are we choosing Him today? Itong mga oras na to, pinipili mo pa rin ba si Jesus? Hindi porket sabi natin eh, siya yung Diyos mo, eh ngayong panibagong araw, siya pa rin ba? Yan. But we are choosing Him today. Yan. You know, I've met a lot of Catholics. Ang pagkakaintindi nila, once they are baptized as Catholic, automatically, they're okay with God. Ay, nabaptize ako eh. Kaya kailangan magpabaptismo tayo para tayo sigurado okay and we can enter the kingdom of God. Also, friends, from born again, no, Christians who think that just because they are prayed over and pray the sinner's prayer and accepted Jesus as personal Lord and Savior, tapos na yon, akala nila okay na yon. I'm born again, okay na ako. No? Faith is like manna. Ano ba yung manna? Remember, sa Biblia, yung mana, hindi mo na pwedeng kainin bukas yon. Ngayon lang yon. Pareho yan. Faith is like mana. You can't use yesterday's faith for tomorrow's battle. I repeat. You can't use yesterday's faith for tomorrow's battle. Hindi mo magagamit yan. You've got to obey Jesus again and again, until the end of time. Yan. Consistently, no? Obey Jesus again and again. Huwag mo sabihin, Lord, kahapon ang bait-bait ko sa iyo. Ngayon, nagkamali lang ako. Di mo na ako paborito. Again and again, you have to obey Jesus. You know, I started the talk by saying that the centurion had strong faith. Very strong faith indeed. For some, strong faith means a life of miracle. Yan. Strong faith means a life of miracle. I believe that. But more than a life of miracle, this is what I believe. I believe strong faith means a life of obedience. Yan. A life of obedience. Let's close with that this military man said to Jesus. Jesus said the word, "From where you are, and my servant will be healed. I know this because I am under the authority of my superior officers, and I have authority over my soldiers. I only need to say, go, and they go, or come, and they come. And if I say to my slave, do this, they will do it." Yan, sinabi ng centurion niya. Alam ko pong pinanggagalingan. Sabi niya ganun. From where you are, no? My servant will be healed, sabi niya. I know. Today, Jesus is asking you, are you under my authority? Come to think of it. Saliksikin mo yung kaibuturan ng puso mo. Are you under my authority? Jesus is asking us, you and me. Will you go when Jesus says go? Pag sinabi ni Jesus, go nap, punta ka dyan. Will you come when say Jesus come? Are you under my authority? Yan, sinasabi ni Lord parati. Are you under my authority? Kaya hindi automatic when you say, Lord, Lord. Remember, when you call Jesus as a Lord, magpapasakop ka sa Kanya. Pero hindi yun ang ibig sabihin. Itong sinasabi natin, tinatawag mo nga siyang Lord, pero are you under the authority of God? Yan. Will you do what Jesus tells you to do? Gagawin mo ba kung anong ginagawa ni Jesus? Will you love your enemy? Will you love your enemy? Will you not be quick to judge and see goodness in the enemy? Yan. Let our earnest prayer be, just say the word. Sabihin mo nga yan, just say the word. Sounds familiar, diba? Just say the words. No? Indeed, because we always proclaim it before taking communion. Naalala mo ba yun? Nasabi natin bago tayo mag-communion. I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Sinasabi natin dyan parati, kung araw-araw ko nagsasabi, dapat alam na alam mo yan. Just say the word, and I will be healed. Yes, this was borrowed from Matthew 8, chapter 8, sa mas natin yan. Doon ang gagaling yan. Iniba lang ng konti ng words. No? Sinasabi natin, just say the words, indeed, and I will be healed. Yan. Friends, if you have to believe again, tell Jesus, Lord, just say the words and I will be healed. My worries will be replaced by my worship. My fear with faith. Just say the word, Jesus. In Jesus' name, just say the word and I will be healed. Yan. Friends, God is inviting us. Just say the word. Let's submit to the authority. And that is our Lord, our God. Make me believe again, Lord, by just say the word, Lord, wherever we may be, and I will be healed. No matter what difficulty you're entering right now, just believe in faith and say, Lord, just say the word that everything, Lord God, will be okay. Just say the word. Can you pray with me? Yeah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we may be able to be judgmental over and over again. We're so overconfident, Lord God, that we are better than anyone else. May we always be reminded, O God, that the true faith is a total obedience to you at all times. total obedience to you, Lord our God. Consistent and faithful till the end. Lord, we will just say the words and everything, Lord God, will come to Lord God as a blessing. Just say the word and all of us will be healed. We submit to you, Lord God, as our authority. Continue to pray, brothers and sisters, as we reflect our music ministry will lead us into a short worship, declaring that you are our Lord and King of our life. Amen, Lord God. Just say the word, O God. Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord.
Praise forever to the
Wow! Thank you, Worship Ministry, for that powerful praise and worship. Lupit niyo talaga. Salamat din sa ating mga feast builders.
Yes, at patuloy po nating suportahan ang The Feast sa pagbibigay tulong sa ating mga mercy ministries. You may share your blessings through tithes and love offering.
Yes, and properly, let's give glory and honor to our Lord as we pray. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen and amen. Maraming salamat po, and see you all next Sunday. Bye!
Secure. I will trust you in the breaking when my prayers are unfulfilled. God, I know you're orchestrated, for you work all things for good. You are good, sovereign, loving and true. You are kind, faithful. There's nothing you can do. I will
what may